Ladies and gentlemen, get ready for the main session of the day. Now we have the guest of honor session by Mr. Amitabh Kant, CEO, Niti Aayog. Over to you, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, a great pleasure for me to participate in this conference. The world is at the cusp of mobility revolution, which is going to be shared, connected, and zero emissions. Our view is that two-wheelers and three-wheelers constitute 80% of total sales. These vehicle categories are the low-hanging fruits in our electrification journey. We should target for 100% electrification of new two-wheelers and three-wheeler sales in the near future. With the size and scale that India offers to these vehicle categories, along with the simultaneous reduction in battery prices, makes them a perfect fit for electrification. An unseen and often missed success story that India has been able to produce in the last 3 to 4 years is of electric rickshaw. Though fraught with some issues, there are more than 20 lakh electric rickshaws running on Indian roads at this point of time. It demonstrates that India is perfectly placed to go for full electrification of two-wheelers and three-wheelers. India is taking lead in manufacturing of electric vehicles, with firms like Ola Electric setting up manufacturing facilities to manufacture for India and the world. The dominance and leadership that India has in the traditional ICE two-wheelers must be replicated in EVs. Other firms like Okinawa, Kinetic Green, Revolt Motors are also pursuing domestic manufacturing and going for maximum localization content. Rapid technological evolution is driving the transportation revolution in the world. Battery technology is evolving rapidly, where prices of battery have fallen more than 90% in the last 10 years to $137 kilowatt hour. It will go below $100 kilowatt hour by 2023. Breakthroughs in battery technology to look beyond lithium and cobalt chemistry are already happening. Solid-state batteries like aluminium air and zinc air are non-flammable and have emerged as winners for operations in high and low volt temperatures. Sodium-ion battery built on abundantly available sodium metal is emerging as an alternative to lithium. Flow batteries, vanadium and ferrous-based, are perfect for grid storage. Companies like QuantumScape, working to build solid-state batteries, have raised more than $1 billion. Indian companies like Log9 have raised $3.5 million and are actively working to promote aluminium fuel cells. The financial viability of electric mobility has made it more acceptable to masses. The total cost of ownership parity has been achieved in all vehicle segments within a 5-year time span. The time span reduces much more in case of commercial vehicles like freight delivery vehicles, which have emerged as the first mover. The upfront cost of EVs is also falling rapidly due to technological innovations across the value chain. Alternative ownership models like battery swapping have actually made the cost of EVs at par with ICE. I would also like to say that the prices of solar in India have reached a record low level of Rs. 1.99 kilowatt hour. This is unprecedented in the world. We can reap its benefit to produce green hydrogen at the cheapest prices in the world. And that should be used to propel our heavy-duty vehicles like trucks and long-haul buses and make them zero emission. The puzzle of reducing emissions from heavy-duty vehicles gets solved by using green hydrogen along with the potential to reduce emissions in industrial sectors. Cities of tomorrow need to embrace the concept of transit-oriented development, where public transport is the backbone. This will be the key determinant of ease of living to provide affordable, inclusive, and safe mobility. A robust zero emissions based public transportation is a must. E-mobility disruption should provide accessible, affordable, inclusive, and safe transportation options to people across the world and in India. The drive towards the electric mobility should not be on personal mobility, otherwise we will be aggravating the issues of congestion and will be never able to provide equitable access to transportation in our citizens. The focus should be on moving towards EVs, but also on moving people and not moving vehicles, which can be achieved through public transportation and its electrification. In this regard, central government has taken multiple steps towards including rolling out of faster adoption and manufacturing of electric vehicles in India, phase 2. With total outlay of rupees 10,000 crores, where nearly 70% of funds are committed towards public and shared transport. Moreover, hiring of electric buses by local authorities have been exempted from GST. Along with this, steps like exemption of requirement of permit for EV transport vehicles will prove to be a game changer for uptake of EV3 vehicles in the country. Electric bikes have seen huge increase in their ridership in the Western world, even during COVID-19 pandemic. The market research firm NPD Group said sales of e-bikes grew 145% in 2020 compared to 2019 in US. This is a trend which is mirrored across the world. India has a huge opportunity to transition a sizable chunk of its annual sales of 2 crore weight cycles to electric, which would transform people's lives, making mobility more affordable and accessible. The PLI scheme for manufacturing of advanced cell chemistry battery has been approved with outlay of the program for the first 5 years at rupees 18,100 crores. The total outlay during the 22-30 period is expected to be 31,600 crores. The program will directly incentivize 50 gigawatt of domestic ACC manufacturing capacity in the country over the 10-year subsidy window. It will help in realizing the goal of Atmanirbhar Bharat by encouraging domestic manufacturing, reducing import dependence, and help make India a global leader in some of the world's largest growth sectors such as consumer electronics, electric vehicles, advanced electricity grids, solar rooftop and housetop, household appliances, among others. The work on other battery chemistries which look beyond lithium and cobalt will also make headway. There's a need for India as the world to harmonize our efforts with the Indian IT industry. India is the world's best IT industry, and we are aware that electric mobility revolution would be driven by power electronics, AI and automation. The electric vehicles would have higher value addition of electronics and IT components than traditional automobile components. The world's best IT sector of India would be an incubator for innovation and R&D of transportation of tomorrow. And this includes not only electric vehicles, but also shared and connected transportation. Ladies and gentlemen, with these few words, I'll conclude, and I wish the conference all the very best.
Thank you, sir, for your time and insightful content. Ladies and gentlemen, let's spread the knowledge on social media using the hashtag ETAutoEVC, as spreading knowledge to the larger audience will serve the very purpose of this conclave. So keep tweeting and stay tuned.